always on go, ayy. And I never questioned if she was the one. I already know, ayy. She be giving that real love.
Hey y'all, what it is? What's up? What's up? What's up, y'all? It is a beautiful Saturday. And we lit over here. I don't know about y'all, but hey, y'all. Today I'm gonna be coming to y'all talking about life as a single parent. Woo! Nah, it's all good, y'all. Anyway. I'm just gonna be sitting here letting y'all in on some FYI for your information. It's a business opportunity. Nah, y'all. Anyway, y'all, I am thankful, and more than anything, I'm glad that I woke up this morning so I could be here with you. But anyway, y'all, I'm gonna be telling y'all, yeah, how it is to be a single parent. First of all, nobody asks to be a single parent. Don't get it twisted. No, you can't sit here and, you know, back in the old days used to be like, oh, the old people used to be like, oh, you're just so fast. Well, it don't matter if you're fast or you're slow. When you have a baby, you didn't make it by yourself. You shouldn't have to take care of it by yourself. But sometimes under certain stipulations and circumstances, you end up having to do it by yourself. But guess what? You are not alone. God, I said that thing in the last vlog. You are never alone. There is always somebody there with you. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm drinking green tea. Unfortunately, I needed to wet this mouth so I can really get it in and talk. My mouth gets real dry when I sit and run my mouth. So yeah, y'all, stay tuned. But yeah, y'all. No, I never would have guessed in a million years I would be a single mother of four raising four beautiful kids by myself. I always thought that, you know what I'm saying, I would get married and have a little small family. I didn't even imagine I was gonna have four kids, but to God be the glory, it's a beautiful thing. And I faced a lot of obstacles along the way, went through a lot of stuff, but I will say that, you know what I'm saying? It's all about staying in there, fighting and going for what you want. The system, you should only use the system for what it's for. The system is there for you so you can get up and move up and step up different levels. And then once you get to that level that you need to be at, you should be able to wane off that system and go ahead and begin to take care of yourself. I can't speak for somebody else. I'm not speaking for you. I'm just speaking for me. Sometimes in life, we had to use that system for what it's for. Get off of that stuff. Get out here, live your life. Do great things. But yeah, y'all, I used the system for whatever I needed to use it for. Man, I was hurt when I couldn't get no more food stamps, because food stamps is important and beneficial to people. I ain't saying it to be funny, but yeah, to God be the glory. But y'all, it has not been easy, to be honest with you. It's been hard. Y'all, I thank God for my mom, my dad, various family members, and more than anything, I thank God for the kids, because without them, I couldn't be shaped and formed into the person that I am. So, you know what I'm saying? I always believe in going for the things that you want and letting nothing stop you. Single parent doesn't mean that you can't do it. Single parent just means that you need to find God. You need to seek him and find him even the more, because he has a purpose and a plan for your life. But due to certain circumstances, you just ended up single. I mean, and you're gonna make it. It's not over. You can do whatever you want to do, but you're gonna make it. Whether you know it or not, you are gonna make it through whatever you're going through. Didn't always have food. I always made sure I fed my kids before I had a meal. Dads, they're in and out. But for a mother, so there are single fathers out here too, but most of us women go through this. And some of us, we have had a hard way. It seemed like every time you get up, you get these extra coins, something else happened. Every time you get up, you get out the hole, you get it together, something else always go wrong, or it's something that always knock you right back down the stairs when you done climbed up all the way to the top. It's something that always hit you real hard and knock you all the way back to that first step. Y'all, first of all, you need to hold on and trust God for all your needs. He's a need meter. He's met all my needs. I've always leaned and depended on him. I've always trusted him for things for me and my children. When times got tough and rough, I went to churches. Churches have gave my kids. They've been here for us consistently. God has allowed so many people to come in our lives to be right here with us and hold our hand. And now we're at a point where we're off the Similac now. So now we have to go to God for ourselves for the things that we need. And God is always amazing, awesome, and always on time with the things that you need. Y'all, it's a lot of, I'm sitting on a lot of nuggets. I am one person that's in this world that's sitting on many nuggets to bless and help somebody out here to get to their next level. So I will never sit here with all the gifts and all the things that's brewing in me and not be able to share and give my testimonies on how God saw me through to be able to help somebody else, or be able to tell you that that storm don't last forever. And girl, sir, when you come out that storm, you say that's right here. Woo! Yes, yes, honey, yes. You be able to say, God, I thank you. Every day you get up, you forget about everything that's going on around you. You might look over there at your husband when you do finally get the man that you want or the woman that you want. You might look over at them and say, God, I thank you. Lord, I knew this thing would go last forever. She said it in that video, being a single parent. But y'all, single parents go through a lot. And I say that to say, depending on what happens with the child's father, that plays a lot on children. I mean, like, they go to school and they might see another person that gets to the school with their father. You got to be behind the scenes praying and nurturing your kids. Like I said in one of my other videos, you need to begin to pack your kids a bag lunch. And I'm not talking about going to your refrigerator and pack them a bag of food. As being a single parent means you got to do everything. No, you ain't got to be the father. You can pray God will consistently be that child's father because he knows whatever that child needs. My mom told me one time, sometimes a seed bearer is just what a seed bearer is. Sometimes a woman or a man can make a child, but God doesn't leave that other person in their life to take care of that child. Sometimes being a single parent is just what it is. You need to be that single parent for that child because that other person is not strong enough to be in that child's life at the moment. Not to say that God will not raise them up, but you can open your mouth and pray and ask God for anything you want to. God still is close to that single parent, whether you're a single parent or not. And he will give you the desires of your heart. If you think not, just get on your knees and ask him for whatever you need right now. And I guarantee access will not be denied. Might not even be delayed, but he will see after you and take care of you and make sure you have what you need. But let's get back to bag lunch. When I say giving the children a bag lunch is packing them the word, feeding the children the word, and letting them know that they're loved. And when they fall down, not always beating the crap out of them, but encouraging them and letting them know that, you know what I'm saying? Look, I'm doing this thing by myself, but I'm really not by myself. God is here with us. And with God, me, you, all of us, we can get through this thing, but we're going to do this together. If we got to fight on our knees, we will do this thing behind closed doors in our prayer closet on our knees. But one way or other, we will get through this thing because God didn't let you get to it, not to bring you through it. So, you know, it's a point where you just have to keep trusting and believing and knowing that it gets better. Before you know it, that child will be grown, up living, making you proud. You'll be like, oh my God. Like, I look back, my oldest son is 24. God forgive me if I got his age wrong. But y'all, he is driving trucks. He's taking good care of himself. He has a girlfriend. He loves his girlfriend unconditionally. She loves him unconditionally. They pull together. They help take care of her parents. Her parents are elderly, and they do things together. And when I sit back and I look back, sometimes I look and I be like, oh my God, I can't believe I raised this young man. Like, he's just, he does things differently. He don't do everything like I taught him. And I don't knock him for that. But to know that I put in all this hard work in him, and he does things in a womanly fashion, it's okay. He's a man. He's still a man. And y'all, he loved the church. Oh God, the drums were his life. So, you know, I just tell you that, you know what I'm saying? Don't give up, keep the faith. It's hard being a single parent, but it's workable. It's workable. I mean, even if, like, I had two, my last two was in diapers at the same time. And trust me, God laid it on some people's hearts. I was in and out the house. I hardly ever saw the kids. I mean, I work. My mom, my aunt, my family, they were amazing with helping me take care of my son. My mom, she's always been a big part of everything and always been here for all of us the same way she does for my brother and his family. She stays. She's a consistent person in our lives. And I just thank God for a loving mother. And I thank God that she's still here to enjoy it with us. My grandma played a part of everything before she passed. But I understand when they say it takes a village to raise children. It takes a village. My daycare provider, she was awesome. Awesome. Just awesome. She worked with me. There were times, y'all, I didn't have enough money to even pay daycare. And she was just amazing with how, you know, she waited patiently. She never talked bad about me behind my back. And she waited until I got the money and I paid her. And, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was great. And I gave back to other people, kids, as I learned how to do things. I always did things for other people, kids. I've always been here for the family, kids. I guess, like, having kids, y'all, I was just a kid myself. When I got pregnant with my oldest son, I was in my last year in high school, and I had him, and I got on the Homeward Bound program, and I ended up graduating anyway. I was just determined. I was determined that nothing was going to stop me from walking across that stage and taking care of my son. I was in JRTC. Y'all talking about a breakdown? I was the company commander for the company. I was bussed down from rank and dropped down to be the XO of the company, which it didn't hurt me. It just made me stronger. It just made me go harder for the things that I wanted in this life. And that's all I'm trying to tell anybody. As a single parent, you have to have dedication. You have to be dependable. You have to stay in the fight. You got to keep pushing. You cannot give up. Those kids depend on you. Like, right now, I'm in the position that I'm in, and I still fight because I still got two or three here that's in the house with me that still depend on me for things. So you can do this. It's nothing hard. It's nothing over the top. The Bible tells us that all things are possible through Christ that strengthen us. You know what I'm saying? All you have to do is have hope, believe, trust him, and he will elevate you and he will take you to different levels. So, you know what I'm saying? He just wants you to be faithful to him and he'll be faithful to you. And I'm talking about God. So don't think I'm talking about the man. The man is just there, honey. If he don't know Jesus, sanctify him. Sanctify a woman of God. Y'all, it just tickles me because, I mean, when I go back and I look at life as being a single parent, yeah, it was hard. And I can laugh now and I can smile because you know, I depended on the system for as long as I needed them. And when it was time for me to get off the system, y'all, I was busted. I was crying. I was like, oh no, they're not finna cut me off like this. Every time, y'all, God wanted to elevate me and I couldn't see that he was elevating me. So every time they would ask for my information, or they, you know how you try to go, you try to hide this, you try to hide that. Y'all ain't got to hide nothing. You ain't got to keep nothing from nobody. That's just God trying to elevate you, to tell you, to break you from the system and get you off of those assistants. And he wants you to rely on him. So all my life, God has been telling me to just lean and depend on him. And I didn't understand it so clear until now. So when I ended up getting my truck driving license, y'all, that was a big break for me. You know what I'm saying? My mom took my kids. She took care of my kids. She's just been like this anchor. God has allowed her to be this deep rooted anchor in my life. Like, if I'm having a bad time right now, I can call her. Or it's like, if I'm down and out, she can feel it, y'all. It's just crazy. It is just crazy, crazy, crazy to have a great human being in your life that can, that just know when something ain't right. She just know when something ain't right. She's always here for me. Whenever I can't do something, she's always here, y'all, even when I can't see my way through. If I'm having a bad day at work, if something not right at work, it's like she already know. She'll sit on that phone, be her silence says it all. I mean, like, she's just amazing with how she conducts herself in my life. So shouts out to mom. But y'all, it's not easy being a single parent, but it's workable. And one day there will be another woman or a man to sit in and help you. That's what I'm waiting on. I'm just waiting on my Boaz to come on in here and build me up, not tear me down. But first, God is allowing me to love me. Then while he's teaching me to love me, he's teaching me how to mold these children into somebody spectacular and important. Y'all, I forgot about that bag lunch. Like I was saying, when you pack those kids that bag lunch, a bag lunch is giving them the word and giving them something to hold on to and letting them know that there's hope no matter what's going on in any situation, in any circumstance, that God is your everything. God will show up and he will show out in your life if you think not. Look at me, honey. All this beauty came from straight from above. It's not from me. Whew. Y'all, look at this flower. I put this together on my own. I love it. It's gorgeous. But y'all, I am not going to hold you any longer. But I just wanted to, yeah, go into some things about being a single parent and let any single parent know. Y'all, I got Bibles all over my house. When I first get me a truck driving job, the first thing I do is go purchase me a Bible, and I take the Lord with me everywhere I go. There's nowhere I can go that he can't go. And I've learned that over time throughout living life, because if he can't go, that means I shouldn't be there. Y'all stay tuned. I'll be back. Please make sure you like. If you can comment. If you can't, I understand, because there's kids reacting on the channel. Sometimes they got the comments turned off. Is that right? They got the comment section turned off. But anyway, if you can leave a comment, please feel free to leave a comment. Share this video with somebody. This is just positive encouragement for single parents. There are resources out here. There's things for you. Go back to school, get your education, go as far as you can, let nothing stop you, and definitely go all the way to the top with God. Don't go without him. Always take him with you wherever you go. Put him first and let him elevate you and stay beside him. Don't get ahead of him, and definitely don't fall behind him, because you don't want to be behind him, because you'd definitely be in the ditch. But anyway, y'all, thank y'all for tuning in. I will be back with another awesome video. Anyway, y'all, stay blessed. Keep your head up. Remain encouraged. You got this. You got this. You got this, y'all.
Yeah.